How's it guys, Manash here, and today we have a bit of an interesting Alliance War video. For this is going to be the first time using the rank 3 Tigra, who I took up a couple of hours after awakening her from that Nexus, that beautiful Nexus that kind of just gave me what I asked for, similar to how I got Shang-Chi and Immortal on Cyber Weekend. Kitty T.O.P. That's all I have to say about that, and today we are doing a full Path 5. Which is why I brought Nick Fury, because there's usually a thing on the first node with Ebb and Flow knockdown right back at it and Force of Wall. So I start the fight by knocking him down, just parry heavy to get that passive fury and remove protection. Then after that I immediately forget that he is debuff immune because of the right back at it node. I was just not on form during this fight. In fact, during this entire evening, like, my section 1 was a little bit sloppy to say the least. I'm trying to bait a special 2, eventually he does throw it, I'm gonna knock him down again just to remove the protection, and then throw my special 2, I get to intercept with it, but unfortunately it actually crits, which it usually does at least once, and the last hit triggers protection, so not much damage, but I'm doing okay just from the basic hits alone as long as I have the passive fury. And then here I made a bit of a mistake where I pushed him to too many charges. I just, you know, wasn't really concentrating and I had too many hits on the special 1 and the disorient didn't do enough for me to lower the rocks charges, but we're still in this fight, still in the decoy phase, so we should be done making mistakes now. And the nice thing about Fury is almost everything he does applies a bleed debuff, so it's quite easy to manage his rock charges like that. And he also doesn't hit too hard to trigger protection. As long as you are in decoy mode, or if you at least have low attack masteries like no glass cannon or courage, then your medium crits might just be under the protection threshold. And Fury does have a fairly high base crit rate, one of the highest in the game I believe, so you just gotta watch out for that. But overall this fight isn't that difficult, just gotta manage the charges and make sure you don't get cornered too easily, I guess. There was a time when I didn't do a very good job at charge management, where I pushed him to 15 and he had about 2/3 of a bar of power, so I did just have to hit his block a couple of times, but otherwise the rest of the fight was fairly straightforward. I fought this thing a few times with Nick Fury and this is definitely my sloppiest, but it is off season and the only fight I'm using Fury for, so I'm not really bothered by it. Alright, and thing goes down, and now we're gonna move on to Professor X with Ebb and Flow knockdown and heavy hitter. So I'm gonna use Guardian for this. He's a pretty good Professor X counter, sort of. I mean, he can parry non-contact hits, which just makes, you know, managing the fight a lot easier or a lot simpler. I did make one mistake here, like I said, sloppy fights, where I actually pushed the falter, I activated it, and then I threw a special attack after missing. So that was a bit of a boo-boo, but fortunately he didn't punish me. Even if he did though, it wouldn't have done that much damage, I'm sure. But yeah, all I'm gonna do now is just throw a special 1 and then a special 2 to finish him off. You can see he's going down fairly steadily already. I mean he's gonna have no more than 50% health by the time I get to that special 2, so yeah, definitely time to let it go since he did have suicide, so the recoil just helped make the fight go a lot faster. But either way, one special 1 might still have been enough just based on his health pool. During the season I might be boosted and then it will definitely be enough. And of course Guardian is also a very good high ground counter as long as he has the armor buff. His energy resistance at max sig is just so high that I can basically ignore the tactic or pretend it doesn't exist for most fights. So I've been using him a lot in war lately, in fact he has been my most used champ during this off season. Alright, now we're gonna move on to the first Tigra fight, which is gonna be an Ebony Maw on node 25, so crumbling armor, footloose, force of wall, and kinetic transference. Quite an annoying one if you ask me, especially now with the bans, because Torch gets banned every war and we used to use him as the go-to counter with pretty much all the pre-fights. So lately I've been using Tigra for it and I gotta say it has not been fun. He usually kicks my butt when I'm using my 5 star, so I was hoping I'd do a lot better with the rank 3, and by a lot better I just mean not dying against him. The main issue I have with him is when he doesn't want to throw specials, like I find this fight a little bit dependent on AI behavior. because you do need to hit him every few seconds to place a neutralize so he doesn't get the footloose buffs, and also that'll prevent him from applying degen to you with the special one, so you don't have to worry too much about dexing if he's cooperating. But power control is also an issue because he has high dispersion with kinetic transference. Is quite an annoying combination, and that's why I use the invulnerability boost. So at least I don't take any damage from the special 3 itself. However, it does apply a degen, although not too much damage. I lost about 30% health. Then the other thing I need to watch out for is the falter if I can't throw my heavies frequently enough. So you try to balance being aggressive enough but not giving him too much power while watching out for the falter. And he's a champ, he can't parry stun very consistently. He's got high ground, a bit of an annoying special too. It just feels like there's so many things to watch out for this fight, which kind of just adds to the difficulty. Also, my Tigra is only sick 40 right now, so my initial charges did not last very long, so I still ended up using two special ones to get them back. I would like to throw more sticks into her, but I used up all my mystics, mostly on Doom and then some on Sorcerer a few months ago, and I'm still saving my generic stones for a certain cosmic champ, so it might be a while before I can get her up to a decent sig level. And then finally, towards the end of the fight, he starts playing a lot more cooperatively, you know, throwing those special ones quite nicely, which are very easy to punish with the heavier attack, and that's what I want him to do, and I can just keep on spamming it, and yeah, he goes down. So I think it's fair to say I am not a great Tigra player by any means. I still have a lot to learn, especially when it comes to timing and spacing for certain champs that she works quite well against. But now that I have a rank 3, I'm starting to get more comfortable using her in war. And during the season, I'll actually be boosted for many of these fights. So now we're in section 2 the next morning, and this is where the quality of the fight starts to improve. So first we have this Professor X with Ebb and Flow Intercept and Sadist. So a fun little matchup for Guardian, and this one does not have suicides, but still, it's gonna take one special one and then a special 2 to finish him off. One thing I forgot to do during this fight is punish his falter, because he takes so long to channel that you can actually trigger his falter and miss, and still punish him just after the falter expires, because he won't be done channeling yet at that time. You just can't take long to punish his special attacks if you want consistent timing. So the fight's going pretty well so far, just gotta trigger one more falter, and then bait one or two more special attacks. Then before I throw my special 2, I'm gonna intercept to get that passive fury and remove protection, just to make sure that it does end him. So not bad with Guardian, I lost 1% health in this fight, which is half of what I lost in the previous fight with him. So now we're gonna move on to the last fight of the video. Although I did take some section 3 fights, I had a lot of help from Suicide Masteries. Not that it was needed, but it kinda just deflates the showcase, so... Now we have America Chavez with Intercept and Mighty Charge, and we're gonna use Tigra again for this fight, cause she just generally works well for Chavez since the special one is so easy to punish, and that's all I really need to focus on for this fight, so it was magnitudes easier than the Ebony Maw. The only other thing I needed to watch out for is if she throws a heavier attack, cause you just don't want her to get that damage reflection charge, although you do have some control over which charges she gets. I thought she would throw more heavier attacks when I tried to parry because of Mighty Charge, but I was a bit fortunate in that regard. And with Tigra's playstyle, you don't really parry that much, you know, if you can just spam heavy attacks and bait special 1. All Mighty Charge really did was allow her to purify my ruptures, so the damage wasn't as great in this fight. But still not bad at all, didn't take too long, and she went down with me staying at 89% health for the entire fight. And I think if my charges didn't fall off so quickly, the damage or at least the fight time would be much better. So yeah, I really need to give her more 6 stones or at least dupe her a few more times. I think I can afford to give her another 20 generics without compromising elsewhere. And then all the mystic stones I get will go towards her, but yeah, that's gonna be it for this one. Hope you guys found me and my average Tigra skills interesting, and as always, thank you for watching, have a wonderful day, and new year, and I'll see you soon.